Who gives this woman to this man in marriage?
Her mother, Han.
Thank you, you may be seated. Welcome, friends and family. On behalf of Bailey and Caleb, thank you for being here today. We are here because of love. A love that is so strong that they decided they want to get the government involved. In all seriousness, a huge thank you to all of us who have joined today. This is a time to celebrate. A time to witness the joining of two hearts. When preparing for today, I started thinking about the meaning of love and marriage. Love is a universal language. We know that poets and writers have written about it. Producers have made movies about it. And the Bible even teaches about it. We agree that love exists that when we have compassion for one another. We agree that love exists when we have when we empathize with one another. We accept it as true that it's love when we come together to celebrate the joining of two individuals as one. I came across an excerpt by an author, Daphne Rose Kingma, and it reads, "In marriage, we say not only I love you today, but always. I promise to love you tomorrow, the next day, and always. In promising always, we promise each other time. We promise to exercise our love, to stretch it large enough to embrace unforeseen realities of our future. We promise to learn to love beyond the levels of our instincts and inclinations. To love in foul weather as well as good. To love in hard times as well as when we are exhilarated in the pleasures of romance. We change because of the promises. We change ourselves according to them. We live in the midst and live differently because of them. We feel protected because of them. Our souls are protected. Our hearts have come home." Caleb and Bailey, I want you to consider the connection between each of you as the foundation for your love. We know from scientific evidence that we're all made from the same atoms. We all know that we breathe the same air. We all know that we bleed. And we know that we all love. Caleb, there is no difference between you and Bailey. Bailey, there is no difference between you and Caleb. The two of you are joining as one. In the book of 1 Corinthians, the Apostle Paul provided us with a beautiful description of the kind of love that marriage needs. He writes, "Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud, it does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres." Caleb and Bailey, I urge you to hold on to that vision of love for one another. Because even though all of us are here today and support you and are rooting for you and backing you, life throws us challenges. In the midst of those challenges, it's the kind of love that Paul was describing that is going to get you through it. At this time, we're going to light the unity candle. Caleb and Bailey, please come. Caleb and Bailey, please take one of each of the smaller candles, and then each one of these represents you as individuals. Caleb and Bailey, please light your candles, take your candles and light the center candle together. This center candle represents the joining of two individuals into one married couple. Do you take Bailey to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death do you part?
Absolutely, yes. I do.
Bailey, do you take Caleb to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, in sickness and health, to love and to cherish until death do you part? Having this kind of love in your hearts for one another, you have chosen to exchange rings as a sign and seal of the promises you are making to each other today. Rings are very large in their significance. They are made of precious metals and stones, and they remind us that love is not cheap or common. But indeed, love is very costly and dear to us. These rings are also made in a circle, and the design tells us that we must love continuous throughout our whole lives, even as the circle of the rings continues. As you wear these rings, whether you're together or even apart for a short time, may these rings be a constant reminder of the promises you are making to each other today. Caleb, do you have a ring for Bailey? Caleb, will you please take this ring and place it on the third finger of Bailey's left hand, and holding her hand in yours, please repeat this promise to her, saying after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my commitment and devotion.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my commitment and devotion.
And love.
And love.
With this ring, I do thee wed.
With this ring, I do thee wed.
Bailey, do you have a ring for Caleb? Bailey, will you please take this ring and place it on his third finger of Caleb's left hand and hold his hand in yours and repeat this promise to him, saying after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my commitment, devotion and love. With this ring, I do thee wed. Caleb, Bailey, you have proclaimed your love for one another. By the power invested in me in the state of Arkansas, it is my pleasure to announce you as man and wife. You may kiss your bride. Your fridge full of good food and drinks, and your heart's full of honesty. If you can do this, I promise you'll have an amazing life. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Caleb Miller. Again, on behalf of Caleb and Bailey, I want to thank you so much for coming.